Welcome to a new video from EU Drumport. The UAS operator is required to keep a log of information about UAS operations in a particular category for a minimum of 3 years. There are several formats in which flight recordings can be made. To maintain a thorough record of all operations, logbooks are available in a variety of physical formats, including books, spreadsheets that have been modified, and even phone or web applications. In this video, we'll show you how to complete the most fundamental sections of a logbook so you can keep track of the flights the operator performs. Now let's get going. Drone operators can keep track of all the hours they have flown in a logbook. It includes every flight the pilot has taken, along with details about the aircraft, location, duration, and other factors. The logbook can also list flights as routine operations and training for the purposes of both teaching and learning. Let's go through some of the most common fields found in a logbook. Check out the article to see the example in a table. The first field you will find in a logbook is date. Enter the date of the operation. Operation location. Include a clear reference to the location where the flight takes place, for example, coordinates. Hours. Record the start and end time of the operation. Aircraft. Make and model. Fill in the aircraft's brand followed by the model. Registration. In this field, add the serial number or registration number of the aircraft. Flight duration. Note the actual flight duration. If multiple flights are carried out successively with no more than 30 minutes between takeoffs, they should be recorded as a single operation. Landings. Record the number of landings made, classifying them as daytime or nighttime landings. Activity. Specify the type of flight carried out, indicating if it was flown in VLOS, BVLOS, in what flight category, open, specific, and the subcategory or standard scenario. Hours. This section will note the number of hours spent on each of the possible pilot roles. Usually, they are recorded as pilot in command, but it could be different in some cases. Pilot in command. Record the total hours flown as the pilot in command. Dual control. If using dual control for the flight, the user of the second control will note the total hours in this field. Student in command. For a student flying the aircraft entirely as the pilot in command, log the flight hours in this section. Student pilot. If training is being conducted using dual control, the student using the second control logs the hours here. Instructor/examiner. The instructor records the hours in this section in addition to noting them in the pilot in command section. And last, remarks. This field will note any special circumstances of the flight. For example, in training, the instructor's name will be recorded here. The number of hours the pilot has flown should be recorded in logbooks. If keeping a paper logbook, you must record the hours on each page. After flipping to the next page, keep adding up the flights while factoring in the total from the previous page. A table, for instance, might be shown like this. In this example, the current page records a total of 25 flight hours. The sum of previous pages amounts to 50 flight hours. Finally, the sum of previous pages with the current page results in a total of 75 flight hours. In summary, there are many different formats for modern logbooks, but the essential information that needs to be entered is always the same. It's imperative that you document every flight, and should an inspection occur, you'll probably have to provide the documentation to the relevant authorities for assessment. For more information regarding a guide for using logbooks for your drone flights, visit eudroneport.com or click the link in the description. Safe flights!